据加总统计，有83%的国人有家人住院需要照顾的经验，但是常常面临到的状况呢，就是找不到看护，以及费用过高，或是呢照顾的品质良莠不齐的状况。以长庚医院来讲，他们有自己管理的一批照护员，而且呢他们会定期的做教育训练，也在照顾的品质上面能够有不错的掌握。
Caretakers are now in high demand in the country, and Ms. Wu is a licensed caretaker that works at Changgun Memorial Hospital.
如果要管管活，必须早上六点就必须起床，要开始做所有的作业。那翻身拍背也要注意一些部位，不能让它压到。那所以我们这样一串的流程下来，有时候都要拖到晚上大概11-12点，我才能休息。但是说休息，我也不是说可以安然的去躺着睡觉。我也必须要时刻去看一下病人的状况，如果说真的有什么不对劲，我也是必须要马上回报护理师这样。
The tasks of taking care of patients can get quite detailed and demanding.
这个部位会比较容易受伤，然后有时候因为我们在搬病人是整个抱过来的时候，如果你没有站好，腰就很容易就这样闪到。
Looking at Changgun Memorial Hospital, caretakers work contract-based and can receive the full amount of their pay, the hospital not taking a cut. The hospital has also made sure that all caretakers working there have a license and is providing the necessary training needed. A nursing chief is also there to overlook everything and make sure things are running smoothly and on track.
一个年纪很大的阿嬷，她必须要协助复健。那这个照顾服务员呢，照顾他的期间，从3000-4000一直喊价到一天要喊到5000块，而且他跟阿嬷说，你必须要每天包我吃饭的钱。这阿嬷呢，但是他又没有好好照顾阿嬷，这阿嬷呢，天天在偷偷的哭。那后来护理师有发现，这个阿嬷为什么常常好像不开心，但有发现到他真的在偷偷掉眼泪，所以有介入处理以后，赶快跟我反映。所以这个阿嬷在当天跟我反映的时候，我有人力，我就立刻优先协助派班了。
With the hospital overseeing everything, not only are caretakers able to have more job security, patients and families in need can also be more assured that they are in the safe hands of a licensed professional and feel more at ease.
我妈妈本来是住在安养院嘛，然后因为生病嘛，然后不舒服，然后就送到那个医院，然后临时都是找不到看护的，因为我自己有一个身心障碍的孩子，我没有办法在那边照顾他，晚上一定必须回来。
According to research from the Taiwan Association of Family Caregivers, when citizens are faced with having a family member hospitalized, 61.7% take leaves of absences from work. 26.7% either switch jobs or decrease their working hours, and 4.6% resort to having to resign from their jobs. 85% of citizens surveyed say they feel stress or anxiety about how to take care of their family members who are ill. With fees of hiring a caretaker being on average NT$2,211 per day, many find it hard to afford when the bills pile up, and 80% surveyed say they are willing to adjust the current insurance fees they pay to include caretaker costs into the national health insurance.
他是用这个白班人力大概是1:2-4人，夜班人力大概是1:6-8人，然后用这个两班的这个模式来做这个人力的配比。那最重要的一个设计是这样哈，就是健保每床给付750点，他一年大概需要158.7亿元，每日的保费大概就是1.87块钱这样子。
With Taiwan heading into the era of an aging society, many are worried about how they will be able to afford yet another cost. NGOs in the country are launching petitions, hoping the National Health Insurance Administration will review and approve of the establishment of a hospital integrated care plan in 2022, aiming that within 3 years, fees for caretakers can be incorporated into the health insurance payment system to provide another option for families all over Taiwan. TVBS English News.